I welcome you all with my love and respects. Today's subject is genetic science behind initiation, diksha. First, I'll share some of the Shastra Pramanas, the eternal truths revealed to and by the ancient and modern rishis. Rishi means mantra drashtaha, who sees mantra. Mantra means the way for liberation, way for higher consciousness, way for higher experiences. Manaha trayate iti mantraha. The words are the paths, truths which shows way to man or to mind is mantraha. So whoever experiences mantra is a rishi. So just today morning I decided that we will have all the great rishis in the Vedic tradition. Some 112 names are recorded. For all of them we will have Murti in our ashram. And we will have the Guru Parampara, that Sannyas Parampara, from Shankara till me. We will have that Murtis, that will be taken care by the Swamis. And these 112 Rishis should be taken care by the Rishi Parampara. And nowhere the Rishi Parampara and Sannyas Parampara, all of them have Murtis. We will do first time. Because always the Rishi Parampara is married. So they don't respect the Sannyas Parampara. Always the Sannyas Parampara unmarried, they don't respect the Rishi Parampara. Never both were living together in one place. We will have the Rishi Parampara and Sannyas Parampara, both Murtis in Bidhi. Because the rishis have contributed so much to the world. And we will institute this Rishi Award also for these modern day rishis. Today I'll give you some of the revelations from the modern day rishis, the scientific discoveries, Shastra Pramanas. Then I'll add some of the discoveries from the ancient rishis, Shastra Pramana, again ancient Shastra Pramana. Then I'll add Atma Pramana, my own experience, so that it can become your own experience for you, Apta Pramana. Russian scientists Grazna Foser and Franz Bludorf, you should see their website, really amazing. They have done a lot of research and articles and very powerful discoveries. I am exactly quoting from their research. The human DNA is a biological internet with evidence that DNA can be influenced and reprogrammed by words and frequencies. Understand? The words and frequencies can directly program your DNA. It is biological internet. They call it as biological internet. These Russian scientists reveal that genetic code of 90% of the junk DNA or dormant DNA, which I was revealing that day, as the Jivatman, self in all of you, the part which these people call as a junk DNA or dormant DNA, but I call as Jivatman DNA, self DNA. 90% of the Jivatman DNA follows the rules of human languages. Understand, it's very powerful. I'm revealing step by step, then I'll connect it. How it can be applied in our life. The third important revelation. Greisner, Fosser and Franz Bludorf compared the rules of syntax, the way in which words are put together to form phrases and sentences, and semantics, study of meaning in language and grammar, and found out that alkalines of our DNA follow a regular grammar and set rules like our language. Always Raghupati Yogi used to tell me, he will teach different yoga for different parts of the body. See, for hands he will give some yoga, for eyes he will give some yoga, for tongue he will give some yoga, for nose he will give some yoga, and the most difficult part to work out is the cheek. Even for that he has some yoga. He'll give some yoga. When I ask him, what is the yoga for brain? He will categorically tell, chant Sanskrit. The Sanskrit language, learn Sanskrit language, chant Sanskrit mantras. You should be surprised. How can brain have yoga by Sanskrit? He will insist that I chant that Surya Namaskar mantras during the postures. He will insist that mantra chanting is done. He used to ask, how can mantra have yoga for brain? But now I know. It's true. I can tell you from my experience, whatever is said and done, a person who speaks a decent cultured language naturally behaves, lives, thinks decently and culturally. I'm really telling you, because I wandered length and breadth of India, I have seen all kinds of dialects, people who speak dialects. I have seen Tamil alone 20 versions, Kongu Tamil and Madurai, Chennai, in Chennai Kuvam Tamil, and North Arcot district Tamil. In that there are different languages, Mudaliyar Tamil, Counter Tamil, all kinds of dialects I have seen. And in North, the different dialects of Bengali, different dialects of Hindi I have seen. I tell you, from my experience I can tell you, the language, the standard of language a person speaks directly affects the way in which he thinks, the way in which he acts. It really affects. There may be exemptions, very few, like a person speaking very cultural language and behaving indecently, very rare exemption. But as a nature, it doesn't happen. As a rule, it's a rule. Exemptions does not break the rule, it only enforces the possibility of existence of the rule. Understand, when I say all these candies are sweet, there may be one or two which are not sweet. That does not mean that rule is broken or weakened. Those two, three exemptions ensures the existence of the rule. Look in the other side. Look from the other side. All exemptions ensure the existence of the greater possibility of the rule. So maybe one or two exemptions. But otherwise, I can say the language they speak, the cultural, cultured, clear, syntax, semantics, grammar they use directly affects the alkalines of our DNA. That is why the neuro-linguistic program, NLP, really does a big transformation. I can tell you. See, NLP is not all. It does not lead to enlightenment, but it surely awakens much more than what you are now. The neuro-linguistic programming surely makes you more alive than what you are now. The next important discovery, truth. Scientist Garje J. says, our DNA can be reprogrammed by speech when words are modulated on correct carrier and frequencies. Again and again and again, the Upanishads are chanted for so many different purposes. Not only your DNA can be altered, I tell you, the Upanishads came from such a high frequency. If a group of people whose DNAs are already altered by this chanting, if they chant, the cosmic DNA can be altered. That is why the chanting and Homa brings rain. It brings whatever we need, the natural positive effects. Why do you think such big tsunami did not touch single temple? See, all over, from Kanyakumari to Chennai, at least 2000 temples are there, which compounds usually gets washed by the wave. At least 2000. Please understand. From Kanyakumari to Chennai, first of all, let us start with Kanyakumari Devi temple. From that to Chennai, Tiruvottiyur, Kashi Vishwanath temple, and Pattinathar Samadhi. At least 2000 temples are there. Tiruchandur, Thoothukudi, just temples are there. Not a single temple was broken or damaged or disturbed. It, we may say, no, coincidence. No. If people whose DNAs are altered, reprogrammed by the sounds and mantras and frequencies, if they sit together and create those frequencies and sounds, the cosmos DNA can be reprogrammed. So a space, bit of cosmos, which is reprogrammed by the reprogrammed system of the body of the master is energy field. Bit of the cosmos, which is reprogrammed by the reprogrammed body of the master is energy field. That is why just very living in that field reprograms many of our DNA. Next truth. Since the basic structure of DNA and language is of same structure, one can simply use words and sentences of human language of proper frequencies. This proves DNA reacts to spoken words with proper frequencies. It directly, this is my own conclusion. Because of these researches, it these researchers directly or indirectly explains and proves how affirmations, hypnosis, words from spiritual masters affect your body and mind directly. This is the power of initiation, the process. Many of you people would have seen the video of people levitating during LEP. If you have attended LEP, you would have seen. I did not do anything. All I did is let your samana be balanced, let the air energy inside you be balanced, let whatever happens inside your body happen. That's all. Affirmation, satya sankalpa, nothing else. Satya sankalpa, over. Immediately, the whole thing fell in place. People started levitating, the raising. Understand, ordinary sankalpa is gravitation, satya sankalpa is levitation. Sankalpa, ordinary sankalpa means will, words, thoughts created, pulls you down, makes you more heavy. Satya sankalpa makes you levitate. That is why whatever is said and done, when you listen to the great truths directly from master, it just gets recorded into your DNA, becomes part of your DNA. This is the science why millions come to listen to the masters, and the how the master's words directly gives experience to people. That's what I call transmission of lamp, initiation. From a lit fire, only you can light the lamp. How much ever you sit and beg, please, please, why don't you lit yourself? How much ever you play and do any drama, any game, light cannot be lit by itself. Only from the lit fire, it can be lit. Transmission of lamp only can happen. Same way, how much ever you sit and talk in ordinary way, no. Only the reprogrammed DNA can transmit that frequency and write words and reprogram your DNA. That process only I call initiation. So it is very important to know the importance of initiation. If you sit and listen to the truth from an ordinary man who has intellectually memorized it, it is called learning, teaching and learning. If you sit and listen to a man who himself is practicing those truths, he is called acharya, you are called shishya. If you sit and listen to those truths, who has experienced it, he is called guru, you are a shishya. If you are listening to those truths from a being whose very DNA is programmed, it is called initiation. He is an incarnation, you are a devotee, it is called initiation. This is what exactly I am doing in inner awakening. Every session of inner awakening is an initiation. Awakening of one DNA. Every session of inner awakening, first working on life means different energy centers, then working on death, the different energy layers, then working on koshas, sheets, different energy sheets, energy fields, then working on the very core of energy. So every session is an initiation into the next step. Your DNA gets reprogrammed for enlightenment. In my life, there is an experience with a group of Tibetan monks. They made me sit inside the bell. Some 10 monks sit around the bell and rub the bell and go on chanting. I never realized the sound can create pain in your hair holes, in your pore. The bell has small holes through which I can breathe, but all the 10 sides they are sitting and rubbing the bell with a small wooden piece. That vibration created that sound. Within 5 minutes your ear stops listening that sound. You can't hear it anymore. But every air pore feels the pain as if a needle is being inserted. And after half an hour the pain also disappears. It becomes like a pleasure. Very strong, deep pleasure. Then they chant the words like, you are deathless, you are painless, you have no hunger, you have no thirst, you have no old age. They chant like this. I now translated in negative way, they don't say you have no old age, they say you are ever young. They say you are always fulfilled, you are immortal. They declare in positive terms. And I was really shocked, because first I thought, what can this do? Maybe a ceremony. I love usually these ceremonies. Anywhere, any ceremony I see, I'll go and sit. Whether it is a Shraddha or I will not bother. Whether it is some sannyas ceremony is going on, or some Shraddha is going on, some ceremony is going on, I'll go and sit. So I saw some ceremony going on. I asked, will you allow me? They said, are you a sannyasi? I said, yes, I left the house long before. Then they put me in that ceremony. I started attending. Then I realized, now I can realize completely the frequencies and language can reprogram your DNA. I can tell you, still I do not have anything called pain in my body. If you have seen me 10 days before in Himalayas, 10-15 days before, there was a big wound, at least 4 to 5 inch wound long, maybe quarter inch depth. There was a bleeding and big wound. It took 5 days for me to realize there was a wound. Something has happened to the hand. Some brahmachari saw and told me. By the time it got healed by itself. Even though body is ordinary body, there is no such thing as pain. Still, it takes so much to push the food inside my system, because there is no such thing as hunger. People have to remind me to drink water continuously, because there is no thirst. The DNA reprogramming, the power of DNA is reprogramming. So your DNA can be reprogrammed by the right words, right chantings, right initiation from the incarnation whose DNA is completely reprogrammed. That is why the words heard from the master spreads inside you like a fire and makes you experience. And another one thing, very funny thing, I'll tell you my experience, then I'll give you the research truth. Now, if you are seeing our website, continuously these N Kalpataru's are going on, E Kalpataru's. And I am talking in more than 20 different languages, Spanish, Portuguese, Slovakian, Germany, and what not, Chinese, Gujarati, Bengali, Hindi, Punjabi, really, 20 different international languages I am talking. People may be thinking, what is going on? No, nothing. I just pick up usually the statements which I use in Kalpataru, the blessings. I pick up those statements and get the translation and read them. From those few statements, I try to manage at least the basic conversation so that people will feel connected. During this exercise, I realized an important thing. All European languages, the words are almost same, and all Vedic languages, the pronunciations are almost same. Like Ashirwad, that word is common in all Indian languages. Ashirwad is Ashirwad, that's all. And same way, the blessing, only little bit of alteration you need to do. Felicitad, bendicias, only small difference, but almost same tone in all European languages. I was surprised, how come the languages happened in different places? How come they all have lot of similar pronunciation and so much of grammar? Almost same, symmetrical grammar. Now I know, from this research, scientist Garja Jaev says, human language did not appear coincidentally, but it is a reflection of our DNA. That is why Kashmir to Kanyakumari, when there was no communication like a telephone, television, telegram, anything, Sahana Avatu is chanted in same frequency. Go to Kashmir Shaivites temples, or Bhavani Mandir, or Vaishnava Devi, and go to Kanyakumari, Kannidevi, Bhagavati Mandir. You will see Sahana Avatu and Purnamatam being chanted in same tone, same frequency. So the language is not just coincident. It is the reflection of our DNA. So, through this I want you to understand three important truths. One, be aware of the words you use. Second, listen to the great words only from the person who has experienced. Third thing, whenever you listen to the great words and higher frequencies from the person who has experienced, whose DNA is reprogrammed, it becomes your experience. That is what is initiation. This is the essence, three messages for you for today. I bless you all to have initiation, an experience, and radiate enlightenment, achieve and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.